Hey, welcome everyone, and thank you for joining us on Rise and Thrive with EHE Health, our new weekly interactive platform where we're going to discuss and learn about things health related together. Today, we're actually discussing how to keep your skin healthy and glowing through the summer months. My name is Alexandra, and I am the HR generalist at EHE, but I'm also a career and lifestyle blogger who just so happens to be obsessed with skincare, and I am so excited to host today's session. Please type any questions that you might have into the comment section, and we'll do our best to answer as many as we can at the end of this session. We have the pleasure to speaking with Carissa Sanchez from HydraFacial Company, and she's going to be our expert today on summer skincare and the HydraFacial technology. So Carissa, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and we'll get kicked off.
Okay. As Alex said, my name is Carissa and I work for the HydraFacial Company. I'm a training and education manager based out of our corporate office in Long Beach, California.
Excellent.
Oh, I guess I should also share. I'm like you, Alex. I'm obsessed with skin, not just, you know, by nature, but I'm also a licensed esthetician. So I can talk about skin all day. I'm such a fanatic.
Awesome. Because we are going to have a lot of questions on this topic and I have questions myself. So.
Okay, perfect. Yes, please, guests, bring your questions and type them into the Q&A box, just like Alex said, because we would love to answer them today.
So let's get started. I think you have a presentation for us to just get us kicked off, right?
I do. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. Just bear with me a minute. Okay, here we go. So I think we pretty much covered the introductions and who we're with. But just in case you guys wanted to have our names, they're typed there at the bottom. Alex, what's your blog? Where can we find you?
You can find me at fbhnyc.com. And I've actually done one blog about skincare and sharing my facial routine. So I am really excited for this so I can kind of add this to my repertoire.
Awesome. Okay, so guys, go follow her blog. Okay, let's get started. So I'll tell you guys a little bit about who HydraFacial is, a little bit about the treatment, and then we'll go over some, you know, annual skincare tips and tricks that are recommended, and then we'll go into a Q&A. So a little bit about the HydraFacial Company is we have over 23 years of innovation. We actually held the first patent for microdermabrasion here in America, which is pretty fantastic. So we didn't start off as being, you know, a hydrodermabrasion device. We sort of evolved from a smoke evacuator to microdermabrasion and then evolved into hydrodermabrasion. So we are really the leader in hydrodermabrasion and we are actually a global brand. So as I said, I'm a training and education manager in Long Beach. We have what are called experience centers, and I lead the one in Long Beach. We have one in Chicago that's ran by Leah Argento. We have another in Florida that is led by Savannah Barrett, and we have one in Dallas as well. And that's just here in America. And once you cross over, we also have experience centers in other countries, like we have one in Asia, one in Spain, and one in Mexico.
Awesome. So for everyone who may not be familiar, what is hydrodermabrasion?
Okay, that's a really great question. I think some of you who are familiar with microdermabrasion kind of get an idea of what hydrodermabrasion is. So I'll just elaborate a bit on it and try to simplify it. Hydrodermabrasion is an aesthetic procedure that exfoliates while simultaneously infusing the skin with nutrient-rich serums. So think of it like it's peeling back those layers of the skin, so it's removing them, then infusing ingredients that can penetrate a little better because there are no barriers to getting into the epidermis. Does that make a little sense?
Yes, revealing that baby skin that we all miss and want.
Exactly, right? So now I'll talk a little bit about the actual treatment, now that you know what hydrodermabrasion is. We like to say 3 steps, 30 minutes, best skin of your life. So this treatment is especially fantastic for those of you that want something that gives you some results without having any social downtime. So you can get this treatment done on your lunch break, if you'd like, or on your way home from work, whatever works for your schedule. And it starts with the first step is to cleanse and peel. So you'll uncover a new layer of skin with gentle exfoliation and relaxing resurfacing. I know sometimes when you hear the word resurfacing, you think like it's going to be a little bit more aggressive, but it is not. It's very gentle. Then we move into the next step, which is extract and hydrate. And those of you who've had facials, and Alex, I'm sure you can attest to this, extractions like give you life after a facial, right? Like we all have a little bit of congestion in our nose, no matter what we're doing for our skin. So you'll get painless extractions with the HydraFacial treatment. So we'll remove debris from your pores with that painless suction, and then we'll nourish with intense moisturizers to really quench the skin. The last thing that you want is after a resurfacing treatment to forget to nourish the skin. And sometimes that can have it depending on where you're going for treatments. But with HydraFacial, you're always going to get these nutrient-rich serums with the treatment.
I know that's so important.
It's super vital for, you know, just overall skin health. And I don't know why my slide just changed. Let's see. And then we will saturate the skin surface with antioxidants and peptides to maximize the glow. And so like those of you that know anything about HydraFacial, or if you Google us after, you're gonna see a lot of comments like, my skin was glowing after my treatment. Like the glow is real. And it's because of you know, one of our proprietary serums that has tons of peptides and really nourishing and hydrating ingredients to lock in everything from the treatment and send you off your way with, you know, a radiant complexion.
That's amazing that you can complete all of this in only 30 minutes.
It's so wild. And, you know, really this even incorporates some time with, you know, your HydraFacialist getting to know you and what your skin needs, because this is the basic treatment. So this is the signature HydraFacial is what it's called, but depending on your skin needs, it can be enhanced. So you really have to rely on your HydraFacialist or your esthetician to make some recommendation based on your specific skin concerns. So it can be 30 minutes up to an hour, depending on what you really want for your skin.
Okay, excellent.
And what's really fantastic about this treatment is that it's, you know, not like some of your other resurfacing treatments that can only be done in the fall or the winter months. This is a safe treatment year round. And that's because it's non-invasive, it's super gentle, yet very effective. It restores your hydration. So this is fantastic, like even during the summer and the spring months when you're maybe spending a little bit more time out in the sun and getting some of that free radical damage, because this is gonna repair it in addition to hydrating it. And the real benefit of that is that it's improving your overall skin health. And why that's important to you is because, you know, skin health doesn't just start at the surface. So if you have a really good home care regimen, that doesn't mean you're doing enough for your skin. You really want, you know, like Alex said earlier, you want to expose that baby skin. So you remove those top layers so everything to penetrate deeper, which then means that your skin health performance is in an optimal state for just everything to be better in your life. Because, you know, beauty truly is a feeling.
So I know that you said this is non-invasive and there's little to no downtime or zero downtime. Is there any pain involved? Because I know people with sensitive skin, they're afraid to go to get a facial or afraid to be poked and prodded. So can you kind of ease some of those concerns?
Absolutely. You know, that's a good point that you make. People are afraid to be poked and prodded, whereas, you know, that's standard with a regular facial, you know, when it comes to extractions. With HydraFacial, every step of it is done with a specific tip that is single use and disposable. So not only is it gentle on the skin, you can rest assured that there's no risk for cross contamination. So it's extremely safe post COVID. So each tip sort of does the work, the suction, the vortex technology, and an esthetician's light touch is all that's needed for a really fantastic HydraFacial.
Great.
It's a great question.
Okay. Yeah, I definitely had some painful extraction. So
yeah, and it can like literally scar you, like, you know, physically and like emotionally, you'll be scarred from getting another facial again. But once you get a HydraFacial, you know, you'll never want to go back to a traditional facial.
Great. They say beauty is pain, but it doesn't have to be.
It doesn't have to be. You know, save the pain for something else. If you're going in the market for something more invasive down the line, you prep your skin health with HydraFacial, It's all gain, no pain. And then you can save the pain for something else like, you know, injectables, lasers, or surgeries, if that's your jam. And we've actually put together some tools for you guys to identify what's needed for your skin. And it's called the Skin Health Pyramid. And think of this along the lines as like the food health pyramid, you know, where there are certain pillars of things that you need to do every day to maintain your overall health. Well, there are some things that we've identified that will actually optimize your skin health. So we're going to go through each pillar individually. And as there are questions, type them along. And Alex, if you have questions, feel free to ask. So these are the things that you should always do for your skin every single day, whether it's summer months, winter months, spring, or fall. You should always be wearing an SPF every single day. I say even if you work from an office, you should be wearing SPF. Think about your drive time getting to the office. Some of us are working from home now. You should still be wearing an SPF that has HEV protection in it. And I think we'll probably get into that at some point in this presentation. Okay. So SPF every single day. You should obviously be drinking lots of water. I either have my HydraFacial Swell bottle or a bottle of water with me at all times. You want to maintain a healthy diet, you know, because, you know, healthy skin and just health in general really stems from within. So you want to maintain a healthy diet for overall skin health. And you want to refrain from smoking. You know, that's really going to take years off of your life and compromise your health in general, not just your skin health.
Absolutely. I feel like I can't harp on this enough, how important it is to have beautiful skin from the inside out. That's exactly where it starts. It's good cell health. And a lot of things like being in the sun for too long or smoking or being exposed to pollutants kill cells internally and externally. So you have to, you're constantly fighting that.
Yeah, exactly. I like to call free radicals like youth stealers because 90% of our aging can actually be attributed to the sun. So think about all those times that you went out and got a sunburn, like you're just aging yourself so much faster. Like you'll never guess, I'm like 86 years old, but I look pretty young. Just kidding. But I do take really good care of my skin and I wear sunblock even when I'm staying home.
It shows for sure.
Your skin too. I can tell you're a skincare fanatic. And then daily and weekly, some things that you should be doing. Every morning and night, you should be cleansing your face. And it's going to vary from person to person. So if you have been sort of using this like cookie cutter regimen and it's not working for you, it's probably because it's not designed for your skin type or your skin concerns. You want to moisturize twice daily or as needed. Some people who have a little bit drier skin or maybe work outside in the elements may need to, you know, sort of rinse and moisturize a little bit more frequently or apply SPF more frequently. But that really depends on your lifestyle. And you should exfoliate weekly with a mask or a scrub. As I stated earlier, products will penetrate and work a little bit better, actually a lot better, when they are put on cleansed and exfoliated skin.
Yes. We do have a question from the audience. So thank you so much for clarifying how often we need to cleanse our skin. But another question that creates a big divide is what temperature the water should be. And I always struggle with this question as well. I've heard cold to lukewarm is best, but what do you advise?
Yes, you are absolutely right. So a lot of skin concerns actually stem from inflammation in the skin. So you always want to do things that are going to minimize inflammation. So think about it when you're putting like scalding hot water on your skin, you're red right after, right? That's inflammation. This is especially important for, you know, clients or just people in general that have hyperpigmentation or rosacea or just sensitive skin in general. Definitely stick with lukewarm to cold water. Every now and then, like after I'm in the sun, I like to actually dip my face in a bowl of ice water. I actually did it this weekend after a beach day with my family. And my partner is like, the things women do for beauty. He's just shaking his head. But it really helps to just soothe the skin and reduce inflammation.
And it helps tighten the skin as well.
Totally. So tightens the skin, helps to tighten those pores. And I mean, come on, it gives you a little boost of energy too without caffeine, which is really nice. And then I actually want to kind of go back to the question about cleansing. I know there are a lot of questions surrounding, you know, how often you should cleanse, what you should do for your skin. And I'm a big fan of cleansing at night with a really good cleanser. Sometimes it can, you know, can contain like exfoliating acids like glycolic or lactic, or like any type of gentle acid. Sorry, my light turns off when I'm not moving. So you want to use like a gentle exfoliating scrub at night, perhaps. And in the morning, just rinse your face with cool water. Because if you're over cleansing and overstimulating your skin, that could then exacerbate breakouts or create breakouts, because when your skin is dry or stripped, it thinks that you need to produce more oil. So what does oil do? It creates breakouts. So kind of keep an eye on how often you're cleansing, what that looks like for you, and try to switch to just rinsing with cool water in the morning.
Yeah. And you also just don't want to strip your skin of those natural oils that were produced overnight as well.
Exactly. It's all about protecting that barrier function so that your skin maintains a glow and looks really healthy. Great questions. Okay, now some of the things that you should be doing monthly and quarterly for your skin is to get a professional treatment to deeply cleanse, extract, and hydrate the skin. What does that sound like, Alex?
HydraFacial.
Yes! Yes, you should definitely be getting HydraFacials, if not monthly, at least quarterly, you know, depending on what your skin concerns are. And even if you think you have really fantastic skin, you can always benefit from something additional, like following a custom treatment plan that targets your specific skin needs, you know, based on what your HydraFacialist recommends or your esthetician, because that's really just going to prevent future damage and really retain the youth that you have and the healthy skin cells and healthy collagen and elastin that's already there. And then what you should be doing annually is you should visit a dermatologist every year for a thorough screening. And so you may look in the mirror and think that there's nothing going on your face that requires the attention of a dermatologist, but they could do a full body scan. So make sure that every year you're going to see your dermatologist. And in fact, a lot of dermatologists actually carry the HydraFacial system in their practice so they can improve skin health and really treat the skin from an early stage.
Absolutely. And just another aside, the EHE exam includes a full body scan by our skilled physicians. So if they find any abnormalities on the surface, we will refer any patients to a certified physician or specialist right away.
That's fantastic. So it's kind of like if it's covered and it's available to you, you should definitely utilize it so that you can really stay ahead of any potential issues with your skin, really get ahead of it.
That's only once a year prevention.
I mean, that's all it takes, really. It does. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so we're actually going to introduce you to another tool that HydraFacial has put out for our consumers, is a skin health assessment. So right now you guys are probably all like thinking about what your regimen looks like, how often you're getting treatments, and you're probably a little bit overwhelmed. So to make this easier for you, we've developed what's called the skin health assessment. So if you all go to assessment.hydrafacial.com, you can actually get your own customized regimen and skin health assessment, and it's free of charge to you. What's great about this is it gives you a little bit of an idea of what you can do for your skin and what would be good for your skin. It also gives you something to take into your HydraFacial appointment to share with your esthetician to say, hey, I've already taken a skin health assessment and this is what it tells me. And Alex, would you want to take the skin health assessment with me now?
I would. I do think I have a great skin regimen, but yes, please put me to the test. I want to know.
Okay. So we're going to get started with a simple set of questions. So I'm going to ask them to you live. Okay. Okay. I'll type in your name for you because I already know that. Age range. Do you care to share that here? I'll share mine if you share yours.
I'm in the 80 age range, just like you.
So we have under 18, 18 to 24, 25 to 34, 35 to 44, 45 to 54, 55 to 64, or 65 plus?
25 to 34.
Okay, it's a really young skin. I'm in the 35 to 44 range. Yikes.
I would never guess.
Thank you. HydraFacial. Okay. All right, so we're getting into the basics. How do you characterize your skin type? Pale, sensitive, burns very easily. Fair, burns easily. Medium, sometimes burns, always tans. Olive, tans fairly easily. Light brown, tans with ease. Dark brown, tans very easily, or deeply pigmented, never burns.
I would say medium.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Now let's take a look at some of your daily habits. On average, how many hours of sleep do you get per night? We have less than 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, or 8+.
7 to 8.
Okay. That's amazing. That's like the sweet spot for me too. I get really grumpy when I get like less than 7 hours of sleep. I'm like a toddler. Okay. How much water do you drink in a day? Less than 6 glasses, 6 to 8 glasses, 8 to 10, or 10+.
Ooh. Okay, I'm gonna reveal myself with this one. I probably have 6 glasses or less. I should be doing more, I know.
Okay, I think we all sort of fall into that category sometimes. You know, we get so busy that, think about it, like it could be 3 o'clock before you know it, and you're like, oh my gosh, I still haven't finished my coffee for the day. So, right. So definitely not getting any water in. So try to keep, you know, you can try to maybe do like a larger water bottle and sort of set a goal for yourself to finish that by the end of the day. And that might help with your water consumption. Okay, let's talk a little bit about your habits. How often do you wash your face? More than twice a day, morning and night, once a day, every couple of days, or rarely?
Once a day. I actually follow your regimen once every night.
Awesome. You definitely know a little bit about skin.
Yeah.
Okay, how would you describe your eating habits? Excellent, I always eat healthy. Pretty good, I usually eat well. Average, eat well with some cheats. Or not great, you eat what's convenient. Or poor, you don't pay much attention.
I would say average. I eat pretty healthy, but I have my cheat days.
Okay, I think we're all there. You know, I ate like a vegan meal last night, and then I made Rice Krispie treats after for dessert. So I love myself a little bit.
Some balance there, right? A little bit of balance.
Yeah. How would you rate your stress level? Low stress all of the time? Low stress most of the time? Depends on the day? High stress most of the time, or high stress all of the time?
I would say depends on the day, for sure.
Okay. And how often do you wear sunscreen? Every day, 4 to 5 days per week? Occasionally when you're outside, rarely, or never?
Every day. And I reapply, yes.
Okay, awesome. That is a good point. Reapply. Most people don't know this, but you should reapply sunscreen at least every 2 hours, depending on the sun protection factor. So if it's like an SPF 50, definitely you should be reapplying every like 1 hour to 2 hours, especially if you're out in the sun.
Right. And it's so convenient now with the sprays. The spray sunscreen is
super convenient. It's really convenient. And if you feel like maybe you're not getting really good coverage with the sprays, just spray it onto your fingertips and tap it into your skin. Or even if you spray it on your skin, just kind of tap it in so you get a really good even distribution of it. No excuses, right, Alex?
Exactly.
Okay, how often do you get professional facials? Every month, every other month, once a quarter, once in a while, or never?
I would say once in a while. I do more at-home facials, but once in a while I'll go to a professional.
Okay. Well, if you ever happen to find yourself in Los Angeles, Chicago, Orlando, or Dallas, let us know and we'll get you set up with one of our training managers for a really good
show. Sure.
Okay, how often do you smoke? Never, a few times a year, a few times a month, a few times a week, or daily?
Never.
Good answer. Okay, and then it says, now let's put your skin health to the test. I don't think you can see it so well. Okay, in general, which of the below best describes your skin? Dry and flaky, a few rough spots, no flaking, nothing visible, feels tight and dry, oily, combination, normal, dry, and oily, normal, or hydrated and supple?
I have combination skin. I've always had combination skin since I was young. So I tailor my skin routine for that.
Okay, perfect. I think a lot of people fall in that category, you know, like oily T-zone, maybe normal to dry in other areas. Okay, how does your skin feel after you wash your face? Really dry and tight, somewhat dry and tight, or completely fine?
Somewhat dry and tight. So that's why I supplement with a lot of oils and moisturizer.
Amazing. I love hearing that. How do your lips typically feel? Extremely dry and chapped, somewhat dry and chapped, pretty normal, or hydrated and plump?
Pretty normal.
Okay.
I just had to check myself.
Okay, take a look at your T-zone. How would you describe the appearance of your pores? Very clogged with lots of blackheads, visible with some blackheads, easily visible but clean, or barely visible?
I would say barely visible.
Barely visible, okay.
But the day is young, so.
No, from where I'm sitting, your skin looks amazing.
Oh, thank you.
How often do you exfoliate at home? 2 to 3 times per week, at least once a week, at least once a month, or rarely, if ever?
At least once a month.
Okay. And are you using like a scrub, a mask, a combination? What are your preferences?
So I feel like our hands are exfoliating our skin. You know, anytime you rub your skin, there's a little bit of exfoliating there, but I do use a exfoliation tool once a month.
Okay, awesome. I like that you're only using it once a month. Some people want to use it every day and then it totally strips the skin.
Right.
Okay, how often do you break out with moderate to severe acne? All the time, 2 to 3 times a month, at least once a month, every few months, or rarely, if ever?
I would say at least once a month.
Okay.
Definitely not immune to a breakout.
Yeah, and you know, I'll share a little tip. You know, I find that a lot of people will say that they get a lot of acne in this area. And oftentimes it has to do with either hormones or your diet. If you have a lot of dairy in your diet, you're going to find a lot of breakouts in this area. So I know I took dairy almost completely out of my diet, except for cheese, because I'm like kind of obsessed with cheese. And it's really eliminated a lot of those really terrible like cystic acne breakouts.
That's a good tip.
Try yeah, I share that with anyone who'll listen. So thank you for letting me share that here. How does your skin feel at the end of the day? Same as in the morning, dry and tired, or oily?
A little bit oily.
Okay. And how does your skin feel if you gently run your finger across your forehead, down your cheek, and across your chin? Is it soft and supple, bumpy and uneven, rough and patchy, oily, or a combination of the above?
It's pretty soft and supple.
It looks pretty soft and supple. How would you describe the overall color or pigmentation of your skin? Lots of discoloration, a few dark spots, red and patchy, minor differences in tone, or even an even consistent tone?
I would say minor differences in tone. I do have a few dark spots.
Okay. I think that's pretty common. And how would you describe the tone of your skin? Dull and tired, a little dull, red and irritated, pretty even, or healthy and bright?
Pretty even.
Okay. How often do you see dark circles? Every day, every few days, occasionally on stressful days, or rarely, if ever?
Occasionally on stressful days. But I think we all kind of have those days.
Definitely. And do you visit your dermatologist at least once a year?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay. It's calculating your score here. Let's see.
Let's see.
I don't know if you can see it. 71. Okay. So this is on a scale of 1 to 100, just so you guys know. I think my last score was a 72. So this is like the average range. And so the skin health assessment rates you on hydration, pores and congestion, and tone and texture. So on hydration, and this is because you don't drink a lot of water, you were at 32 out of 50. So that's the area that I think has the most area of opportunity. Pores and congestion, you were rated a 17 out of 25. And that's probably because you experience a little bit of oiliness with your skin. And tone and texture, 22 out of 25. So that's pretty good. So the overall average is 67, just so you don't feel bad about yourself. And the average age group is 64. So you're doing better than most in your age range, which is pretty cool. So that's nice about the assessment. Like, even if we score low, we look at the averages and it sort of makes us feel a little bit better. And then we'll take it a step further, and you guys recognize the skin health pyramid, right, that we just covered. So as you go through, you're actually going to get some recommendations for your skin annually. Great job. Keep seeing your dermatologist at least once a year for a full body scan. We recommend monthly and quarterly to get a regular HydraFacial regimen. Focus on clearing up your skin's congestion. You can do this by getting a HydraFacial treatment every 4 to 6 weeks. And you can personalize your HydraFacial with a hydration booster. And that will help to moisturize and really refresh your skin. And daily and weekly, your skin could use some additional hydration help. Make sure to apply moisturizer once or twice a day. So maybe on the days that you're feeling like you haven't had a lot of water, you just infuse a little bit more nutrients. And then always, you indicated you don't drink enough water. Staying hydrated will help your skin from the inside out. And stress has a huge impact on your skin. Make overall wellness and relaxation a priority. So what I'm hearing is I think you might need a vacation sometime soon. Where you're sitting down just drinking water and maybe meditating.
That's feedback that I can get behind, okay?
And
how personalized this is.
Yeah, it's super personalized. And then you can also email yourself the results. I mean, you can take screenshots, of course, but you can then email yourself results so that you have them handy. So when the HydraFacial partnership is available at EHE, you have your personalized, everyone has their personalized recommendation for their esthetician.
Awesome.
So bad, right?
Yeah. I feel like I'm going to take this assessment after I make a few lifestyle changes and see where I'm at. And I'd love to share it. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's great. It's pretty cool because you can sort of check on your own skin like every month or every 2 months, sort of set additional goals for yourself. Like, okay, now your goal, Alex, is just to drink more water. It seems like you're getting ample sleep. And if you just drink a little bit more water, that'll really improve your skin overall. And then next month after you've made that
adjustment, water bottle ready to go.
You can assess again in 30 days and see what's going on with your skin.
Awesome.
And again, this will just hold everyone over until you're able to get in and see your HydraFacialist, but we would like to, you know, remind you of a summertime checklist for your skin.
Oh, also, just one thing, we will make sure to drop the assessment link right after this webinar is complete.
Awesome. So yes, definitely maintain your glow during the summer with healthy skincare habits, drinking lots of water, make that appointment with your dermatologist. I know I had an appointment scheduled, but then we went on lockdown, so I had to postpone it. So now hopefully I can get in to see them soon, but everyone should do the same.
Absolutely.
Now, what additional questions do we have from our guests?
Let's see, I think we have a few questions actually. So. First one from an anonymous attendee, I use a daily moisturizer with SPF in it. Would you recommend additionally applying sunscreen on top of that?
Well, that really depends on the sun protection factor included in it. So if your daily moisturizer or your makeup has SPF 15, that's only going to protect you for virtually like 15 minutes. So you should definitely start after your moisturizer, get in the habit of putting on sunblock separately. So you'll have two layers of protection before you put on your makeup or before you just walk out the door. Great question. And then again, reapply every 2 hours, especially when you're out in the sun. I know, like, I wear makeup pretty much daily, and there are powder, like mineral powder sunscreens available. I know Zio makes one, and so does Color Science, that you can actually apply over your makeup so you can continue to protect yourself. And my little tip for sunblock is to apply it to the back of your hands as well, because when you're driving, your hands are directly exposed to UV damage, so you want to make sure you're protecting your hands as well. And your face ends here. Anything you're doing for your face, you want to take all the way down through your neck and your décolleté.
Those are all really great tips.
Sorry, I'm very long-winded because I just
love. Oh, no. Next question. I've been seeing a lot of blue light fighting products lately. Could you explain what that protects against?
Oh, yeah, that's a really great question. You know, I usually wear like blue light glasses. I have really good vision, but the blue lights glasses really protect you from like just being tired and from HEV, which is high energy visible light. And there are a lot of sunscreens that will actually, or sunblocks that will protect you from HEV. So look for that HEV protection. That's HEV protection. And that'll protect you from, you know, the blue lights from all of your devices, whether it's your computer screen that you're sitting in front of all day, your phone, your iPad, all of those devices. It's a really great question.
So I personally have a question. There is a skin challenge that has come along with the new COVID world that we live in. So mask acne, hopefully wear our masks when mandated, but how can we prevent the subsequent acne that comes along with extended mask wear?
Okay, well, you should definitely wash your mask every day after you use it, unless it's disposable. Obviously, just toss it out. Do not reuse it. You want to make sure that you're washing your mask with like the hottest water that you could find, because that's going to kill all of the bacteria that lives on it, not only from what you're breathing in, or it's stopping what you're breathing in. It's also going to protect from the bacteria from your face or any makeup. You know, at HydraFacial, we've launched what are called the Face Life masks, and they're white. They're really fantastic, and they have copper infused into the fabric, but because they're white, they get really dirty. I don't know if you can see it, tell, but my mask is really dirty from my makeup just from this morning. So if I don't wash this, I'm definitely going to get that mask knee. And I'm guilty of doing that with one of my black masks. Totally broke out, and I'll never do that again. So make sure that you're definitely washing your mask every single day or just tossing it out at the end of the day. That'll really help. And then obviously once you're able to get HydraFacials again, go in and get a HydraFacial, because it's really gonna infuse like some antibacterial products into your skin as well, and exfoliate and then nourish so that your skin can heal from the maskne.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Carissa, for sharing all these tips, sharing the HydraFacial technology with everybody. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram for additional content. I'll be also writing an article about today's session on my own blog. That's fbhnyc.com. So be sure to check it out. Next, tune in next time for another Thrive Now episode. Thank you again, Carissa, for joining. I think you have a
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, I think you have a final video for us to watch, right?
I do. This will just give you a little flavor of, you know, the excitement that we have here at HydraFacial and the vibe that we try to put out into the community. So thank you guys for tuning in, like Alex said. In addition, follow the HydraFacial company on all social platforms for additional skin tips and tricks. And you can also find me on Instagram at The Beauty Saint, where I post a lot on my stories about HydraFacial. And I also have a beauty blog, but I didn't share it because I haven't written in it in over a year since I started with HydraFacial. But I'm going to follow your blog, Alex, and I can't wait to see what you write about. So thanks for joining us, everyone.
Yes, thank you, everybody. Thanks, Carissa. Mm-hmm. Thanks for sharing, Carissa.
All right, thanks. Hope everyone's staying safe and healthy right now. Hope to see you guys getting your HydraFacial soon.
Thanks. I will be. As soon as we get back up and running with everything, I want to try it out for sure.
Yes, you have to, Alex. We'll stay in touch, and I can get you in touch with the provider in your area.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Bye.